San Miguel is betting big on Mindanao, and with a leadership shift, it's really not surprising.
You must remember, the incoming president is from Mindanao.
Ang says they're planning to put up three more industrial estates in Mindanao on top of the one they already have in Davao.
Ongoing yung negotiation with landowners. Once na magkasundo yun, tatayuan namin ulit ng power plant yun, tsaka pier, and i-convert yung lugar niya para maging industrial estate. Alam niyo ba kung bakit napakaraming job opportunity sa China tsaka sa Thailand noon? Nagsimula po sila na ganun, puro industrial estate.
Each estate will be around 2,000 hectares in size, will be registered with the Philippine Economic Zone Authority, or PEZA, to make it easier for investors to locate, and will have at least one 300-megawatt power plant. With 1 megawatt requiring $2 million of capital, that's easily $600 million in investment per estate, or $1.8 billion for all three. Ang is also bullish about the construction industry.
Hopefully, baka makapagtayo kami ng steel mills sa Mindanao, sa Davao.
Ang says Petron aims to grow profit this year by at least threefold. It also plans to add 5,000 new retail stations, 12 of it along the Tarlac-Pangasinan-La Union Expressway. Ang also had this to say about the plans of the presumptive president to give key positions in the cabinet to the Communist Party of the Philippines.
Kahit sinong grupo yung Pilipino pa rin yung ma-appoint. Huwag ko kayo mag-alala kung siya ay medyo may pagkakuan, kaliwa, whatever, most likely UP graduate yun. Kababayan natin yun, kaibigan natin yun. Di ba? Wala rin problema yun. Usually, pag kami pagbabago ng gobyerno, usually ang mga nag-aalala, mga foreigner.
On plans to bring Davao City's liquor ban to a national level, Ang says he's not worried.
Yung consumption, hindi pa rin lilit yun kasi bibilisan lang ang inom nun eh. Para makauwi na kagad.
Bibili lang mas maagad.
Oo. Aagaan ng inom, tsaka aagaan ng uwi. Di tapos na.
There's definitely a lot of optimism about the upcoming Duterte leadership, even in the business community. But just as Duterte should walk his tough talk, the real test for these businessmen is when they finally put their money where their mouths are. Michelle Ang, ABS-CBN News.